dear students, so I am Dinesh Kaushik here from Manulog Classroom. Today we are going to discuss how should we approach for the quantitative techniques and the logical reasoning section in CLAT exam. So our target, our strategy should be for CLAT 2021 as well as 2020. As you know that recently the dates are out for CLAT 2021 and it is expected to be conducted on 23rd July. Roughly, you are having 38 days. So how you should approach, what should be the reference study material, what should be the daily study plan, how many hours you should devote to each section. All of these things I am going to discuss in the coming week. Okay, my dear? So I am going to share a PPT with you, how to prepare quantitative technique and logical reasoning for CLAT 2021 as well as 2020. My dear, approach should be same, only the difference will be of the timings. Okay, so here you can see that the date and the pattern of the exam. So the date is 23rd July 2021. So you are having 38 days, I am taking it roughly to 35 days. Give it up. Your timings will be 2 to 4 p.m. So that is the problem for most of the aspirants. The reason being, this is generally the sleeping time for most of the aspirants. So my dear, it is a humble request to all of you guys, those who want to seriously crack this exam, please make this time 2 to 4 p.m. as your study time. Fine, because there is a biological clock in our mind. So we, if you want to optimize your performance at a particular time, you should make your brain habitual of performing during that time. Okay, so stop sleeping at this time and start studying during this time. Okay, so this year the exam will be paper and pen based. It is offline exam. Number of questions, it will be 120. Earlier it used to be 150. Okay, my dear. Because of the COVID, they have changed the number of questions to 120. So it is 2 hours exam. Timings they have kept same, but the number of questions have been reduced from 150 to 120. So my dear, this year you will be getting 1 minute per question. Okay. No descriptive section in the exam. Okay, now let's move forward. So earlier when the exam used to be of 150 questions, that is 150 marks paper, then the number of questions from English was in the range 28 to 32. Current affairs 35 to 36 questions. Legal reasoning 38 to 40 questions. Logical reasoning 28 to 32. Quantitative aptitude 13 to 16. So today we will be focusing on logical reasoning and the quantitative technique. My dear, as you know that this year the number of questions has been reduced, it is 120. So in the same proportion, number of questions that we are expecting from the different section will also be less in the same proportion. For example, in the English 28 to 32, it may become in the range 21 to 23 questions. Current affairs, it can become in the range of 28 to 30 questions. Legal reasoning, also in the range of 30 to 32 questions. Logical reasoning, you can expect questions from 20 to 22 questions. Quantitative aptitude, 10 to 12 questions. My dear, when the exam used to be of 150 marks, to get into a good college, if I'm talking about a general candidate, general score, 90 plus used to be a good score. But this year, the number of questions have been less. So exam will be of 120 marks. So to get a good college, I think 75 plus should be your time. I am not reducing the target very much. The reason being, the time is same, 120 minutes. Time is same, all the number of questions is reduced, but the time you will be getting per question has also been increased. So that's why cut off will be slightly less, not that much. Okay, my dear. Now, most of the student, what they do, they ignore this section, quantitative techniques. This is a kind of entirely new subject for most of the people who are not from the engineering background or those students who haven't studied maths. For them, this is an entirely new subject. My dear, one thing I want to tell you, quantitative technique and maths are two different things. Quantitative aptitude means the questions that you can solve logically, okay? Like the daily life question, that is the 10th standard mathematics. It is not hardcore mathematics like integration, differentiation, something like that. So you have very elementary mathematics, that of the 10th standard. So my dear, to get into a good college, I would say this is the differentiating factor, quantitative technique as well as the logical reasoning. The reason being, most of the students, suppose I'm saying 75,000 people are appearing for the exam. Out of 75,000, my dear, I'm saying I can bet somewhere around 10,000 to 15,000 people are the serious candidates. Rest is just crowd. The competition is among these top 10,000 to 15,000 people. And my dear, to get into a good B college, every single mark, to get into a good law college, every single mark matters a lot. Quantitative aptitude, if you are getting a correct answer, then you will be getting plus one mark. But what happens in English section, most of the people will be attempting the question, but they will not be that much confident about that. Current affairs also, if someone knows the options, someone has a kind of doubt in the option, then still those people end up attempting the question. But in quantitative aptitude, if you are getting the answer in your option, there are very high chances that you have done the question in a proper manner and you will be getting a plus. So my dear, this section doesn't require that much time. If you target on some specific topics, then you can crack this exam very easily. So I am going to tell you the important topics as well as the sources also. Right, so you know the different sections, these are the five sections. So we will be focusing on the syllabus of logical reasoning as well as the quantitative techniques. So quantitative techniques, if you see the syllabus in the notification, this is the syllabus they have given. Okay, my dear. So they are saying that the short set of facts and propositions, graphs, or the external textual pictures, diagrammatic representation of the numerical information formed by a series of sequence, derive inference and manipulate numerical information. It means the theme of this story is that you will be having two types of questions to prepare this exam. One is your elementary maths and another is the data interpretation. Data interpretation is nothing but a revision of or the extended version of elementary mathematics. So I am going to tell you some of the very basic chapters. So for this, you need to prepare your ratios, percentage, profit, loss and discount. Then time, speed and distance, average mixtures and allegations, sometimes they may ask questions on permutation and combination and problem. Fine. Apart from this, geometry and length. So my dear aspirant, please focus on the chapters 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Try to work upon these 9 chapters and you will ace through this Okay. What is the reference study material? You can refer R.S. Agarwal. This is a good book. And if you don't want to purchase this, there is another book that is Magic Book by Quicker Maths by M. Tyra. M. Tyra is the publication. Quicker Maths. Right? This book comes with the name of Quicker Maths or the Magic Book on Maths. Quicker Maths by M. Tyra. You please remember this, M. Tyra. You purchase this book and start working on it. You are not supposed to attend all the chapters. The chapters that I have mentioned here, please go through those chapters only. And once you are through with the chapters, then you can go for the data interpretation section. In data interpretation, you can see the tables, bar graph, line graph, pie chart, and Venn diagram. So these are also given in the book after this mathematics section. This is the syllabus for logical reasoning. For logical reasoning, here basically most of the students face problem in the critical reasoning section. So my dear, for this you can refer the book by M. Pandey or Willy Publication. This book is basically written for GMAT, but this is an excellent book. Fine. You are not supposed to go through this book entirely. On every area, you just attempt 10 to 15 questions. So like assumption, argument, premises, right? Strengthening and weakening of the situation. So please go through this book, and whenever you feel tired after your study, in the break time you can attempt some questions from like the sitting arrangement, clocks, calendars. You can attempt those. So this book is a very nice and very busy book. It is a bit bulky, but you are not supposed to attempt all the questions. Every chapter, there are so many questions. Right? So attempt somewhere around 10 to 15 questions from each chapter. Now, let us focus how you can, those aspirants who are appearing this year, 2021, they are left with 35 days, how they can ace this exam. My dear, first of all, please say no to social media. Fine. So whether it is Facebook, WhatsApp, whatever it is, please stop using this at least for 1 month. Okay. Or if you don't want to uninstall your WhatsApp or some important information is there, please fix 30 minutes a day. It should not be in the early morning. So whenever you feel free, like you will be taking a break or you will be having lunch or your food, during that time you can use your mobile phone for just 30 minutes. After that you will not be keeping mobile phone with you. Okay, my dear, this is really very, very important. Otherwise, what happens when you are studying, you are sitting on a chair, you think that you have studied for 3 hours, but continuously you get distracted by the messages you are receiving from your friends, your relatives, whoever is that. And not only that time when you are reading the messages, but that those messages are distracting you. Fine. So please fix any time that is not, that you think that it is not that much productive for your preparation point of view, use those 30 minutes for your mobile access. Okay, Pita? For the next 35 days, you should study. If you want to get into a great college, then you have to devote 10 to 12 hours. I am taking an average of 10 hours. If you are studying for 10 hours, so roughly you will be having 350 hours. So it should be slightly more than that, but I am taking 350 hours. So how do you break up these 350 hours? My dear, I am breaking this into 6 parts. 5 areas of your test and 5 areas that you will be getting in the notification. And this is really important. You have to write mock test. So many students think that once I complete the syllabus, then only I will start writing the test. That is a very poor approach, my dear. So from day one only, I would recommend you to go for some tests. So, and always prefer writing a test from 2 to 5 p.m. So, because your actual exam is also going to be conducted during this time from 2 to 4 p.m. So, always make this time as your testing time. So, my dear, I have written here that you have to attempt 25 mocks, minimum 25 mocks, for that you have to devote 100 hours. How you are getting 100 hours? Because, my dear, writing a test is important, but what is more important is analysis of the test. So 25 tests you will be writing, it means 50 hours you will be writing the test. Fine. After that, 50 hours should be analysis. 50 hours should be the analysis. Analysis in the sense, first of all, see those questions which you attempted in the exam and you got them wrong. So you attempted in the exam, it means you thought that you know the answer to those questions and you are getting them wrong. It means, was there any silly mistake or there was some conceptual problem? So please start working upon those area. So during these 50 hours or every day after a test, you have to devote 2 hours to identify what are your mistakes and what is the area on which you have to work upon. Please identify some of the area. In every test, you will find some topics you are not that much comfortable with. Start working upon those topics. So other than this, 30 hours you can devote to English, current affairs you can devote 70 hours, legal aptitude 70 hours, logical reasoning 40 hours, quantitative aptitude 40 hours. Okay, my dear, and these 35 days, I am breaking these 35 days as earlier I have given you the hourly breakup, now day wise breakup. So, my dear, first 10 days, you should start working upon the weakest area. Okay, so what happens with the most of the students, they keep on attempting the questions or they keep on working on the area and they are very comfortable. Suppose you are very good at logical reasoning. So there is no point that you keep on attempting the question from logical ability. So because the weakest area has the maximum scope of improvement. So I would say the first 10 days you have to work upon your weakest area so that you get some confidence in this area and you can attempt the question from this. Next 20 days, for the next 20 days, you will be completing the syllabus. I am assuming that you have already studied and you have already planned your preparation for this exam. You have devoted some time. So for the next 20 days, you will be making concise notes and you will be completing the syllabus. So during these notes, your notes should be very concise so that you can utilize the last 5 days for the revision of the notes. Don't write everything on your notes, in your notes. Otherwise, it will become very difficult for you to revise the syllabus in the last 5 days. So your notes should be good, explanatory, but very concise also, so that you can revise them at least 2 times during the last 5 days. Okay, my dear, you guys will implement this strategy and get a decent score. Thank you very much.